What's up, YouTube? AJ Gergich here, founder of Gergich & Company. Today, I'm excited to show you a brand new website crawler that just dropped. Now, this is used for doing site audits and technical SEO audits. This tool has everything the power user needs, but also gives a lot of hints and details for people who are just getting into SEO, or maybe they just do SEO on the side for their blog and things like that. This tool can really help you out. You can see here, I am on the free trial. There's a 14-day free trial, and it's you don't even have to put a credit card in to try it out. So definitely try it out. There is a free version. You get 500 URLs per month, and the pro version is around $35 a month, and it's pretty much unlimited. Here we're looking at, I did Dropbox yesterday. Scanned it pretty quickly, and it's just a really beautiful tool, very visual, shows you everything. Everything is downloadable as images, if it's like a pie chart and things like that, so you can get it out. If it's data, you can export it into Excel. It has the typical things that you're used to seeing, like here are, you know, your word counts, your duplicate meta descriptions, all the things that you're kind of used to seeing in these types of tools. But what I really, where I think this tool shines is it gives advisory notices, and also where it thinks like this is an important issue. So here the meta description is either missing or empty, and it tells you if that content is indexable, and that way you should probably care about it, or if it was non-indexable and maybe it's not a priority. When you click in on indexable, you can download this right to Excel. So you have this whole sheet where you can see where the issues exactly are. And in this case, we have 5,000 URLs. Let's say you wanted to filter that down and you said, I want it to contain DA underscore DK, oops, hit apply. And you can see that it'll filter that right to there, and then you could export that. So it's really easy, and you can add and remove columns, really easy to work with. You don't have to be super technical to get everything to work properly. So one of the things I wanted to test right away, though, for more international websites or enterprise websites, href language is a big problem. So if you click here on international, you can see that they have taken this on. And essentially what it is it's not complicated. It's just tags that you need to place on the site and said, okay, this is the German version of our site. This is the Spanish version. And you can see Dropbox here, they have all these different versions. But what happens is all of these tags need to, be self-referential. They need to make sure the links have the correct syntax, they're not broken. Maybe even a no index tag somewhere could be conflicting with these. And once you're dealing with enterprise sites, this can get messy super fast, and it's a huge, huge headache to untangle. And this SiteBulb really shines here. So you can see right when I go into hints, it's saying, oh, these have invalid outgoing hreflang annotations. And if you're like, what the heck is that? Again, it gives you some context around what's happening here. And then all you got to do is click in and boom, you're on to the issues. You can export it and start solving some of these problems. But this saves a ton of work. Some of these are just, advisory where they're saying, hey, maybe it's missing on purpose. You didn't need it there. But a lot of these, like this invalid HTML lang attribute, these are just errors, and it's catching them, and it's, looking at a lot of different things. So you don't have to. You can connect to Google Search Console or Google Analytics. There's a really cool site speed feature here, and you can get lots of data about your site and how fast it is. And then it gives little hints, and they're very detailed what it's looking at. Also with resources, like here, it knows that they haven't minified their CSS file, which means basically taking out all those spaces and junk. Even mobile rendering, I was pretty shocked to see that it saw some fonts that wasn't, properly legible potentially on mobile devices. So, this kind of has it all, but I love, love, love that it is also giving you those hints. There's one last feature I'll show you. And this is the crawl map if you're a visual person. Now, this is Dropbox, so their crawl map is insane. Yours most likely will not look like this, but you can zoom in and start to see, you know, this is, yep, that's the main domain for Dropbox. And you can see the depth, its link equity score, how many unique followed links are to it, and all that kind of stuff. And you start to look at its children and how deep everything is in the site. Now, this one is quite complicated, like I said, but if you're a visual person and you might want to just look at this, and what you're really looking for is, are your important pages, you know, way off in the boondocks, or are they surrounding the homepage? If they're not, you might want to look at your architecture and make sure that it is putting your most important pages first. SiteBulb, guys, try it out. I'm pumped. This is a tool that we've been waiting for a long time. Down in the comments, let me know what you think. Any features that are missing, you know, maybe I can pass those on to the developers, or just your overall thoughts on it. I think for something that just came out, they have done a phenomenal job. I'll see you guys in the next video.